Hello, everyone. Another mind-boggling thing about deep space is the estimation of how big it is. For example, our own galaxy, the way we treat the Milky Way galaxy is a huge collection of stars, dust, and gas. The sun is about 25,000 light years from the center of the galaxy. Even if you traveled at the speed of light, it would take you about 25,000 years to reach the center of the Milky Way. The Milky Way got its name from a Greek myth about Hera spewing milk. However, the galaxy is known by different names in different points of the planet. In China, it is called the Silver River, and in the Kalahari Desert of southern Africa, it is called the Backbone. Studying the Milky Way used to be very difficult. Astronomers have described it as trying to understand the size and structure of the forest while being lost in a dark forest. We don't know how to get perspective from a vantage point on Earth, but two groundbreaking space telescopes launched since the 1990s helped usher in the golden age of Milky Way research. The galactic disk extends beyond the bulge, 100,000 light years across and 1,000 light years thick. This structure is home to the vast majority of the galaxy's stars, including our sun. Known as the supermassive black hole, Sagittarius A is located at the center of the Milky Way. It scatters stars, stardust, and gas clouds in the disk. Discovered in 1974, the black hole has a mass of 4 million suns and can be seen in the sky with radio telescopes near the constellation Sagittarius. Everything else in the galaxy revolves around this powerful portal to oblivion. The densely packed region of dust, gas, and stars surrounding it is called the Galactic Bulge. The Galactic Bulge is peanut-shaped and 10,000 light-years wide and is home to 10 billion of the Milky Way's total of about 200 billion stars. Beyond the bulge is the galactic disk. This 100,000 light-years wide and 1,000 light-years thick disk is home to the vast majority of the galaxy's stars, including our sun. Stardust and gas clouds scatter stars in the disk. The stars in the disk orbit the galactic center, forming spiral arms that spring out from the galactic bulge. The mechanisms leading to the formation of spiral arms are still being investigated today. However, the latest findings show that these arms are within 13 billion years of evolution of the galaxy. It shows that it formed and dispersed in relatively short periods of time, up to 100 million years. Our sun is about 26,000 light years from the black hole Sagittarius A, located roughly at the center of the galactic disk. It takes 230 million years for the sun to complete one full orbit around the galactic center and moves at 828,000 kilometers per hour. All this is surrounded by a spherical halo of dust and gas, twice the diameter of the disk. Astronomers believe that the entire galaxy is surrounded by a halo of dark matter. But dark matter, which can be indirectly inferred from the gravitational effects of stars in the galaxy, does not emit light. According to calculations, this matter makes up 90% of the galaxy's mass. Clutter of the Milky Way galaxy, including dark matter, it is scattered among the visible celestial bodies in the galaxy, along with 200 billion stars and huge gas clouds that fill the stars. Located in the center of the Milky Way, these objects were so large that researchers were shocked when they measured their size. What high-energy radiation they emitted! Astronomers working with the Fermi Gamma Ray Space Telescope have discovered that these two massive blocks, known as Fermi bubbles, are rising from the core of the Milky Way galaxy. Fermi bubbles stretch more than 25,000 light years above and below the plane of our galaxy. Glaciers in Antarctica have reported 10 super high energy neutrinos originating from bubbles, prompting some astrophysicists to think crazy subatomic interactions are taking place. So how did the Fermi bubbles originate? This is totally confusing. Normally, it is very difficult to make large, hot gas clouds for stars because they require significant energy resources. A typical galaxy does not have the kind of energy that could radiate hot gas over 25,000 light years. The peculiar orientation of the Fermi bubbles, which lie equally above and below our galactic center, is a strong clue that they may be connected. Perhaps the black hole Sagittarius A, located at the center of our galaxy, began to engulf a large celestial body millions of years ago. The turbulence experienced in the polar regions throws most of the matter out of the galaxy. These particles spread out and thinned while trying to escape to a safe zone, but have remained energetic until today. Astronomers have observed such a phenomenon in other galaxies, and it is not known whether the Milky Way black hole has an active eruption today, but it may have happened millions of years ago. Approaching the black hole, the star broke into pieces and released all this strong gravitational energy in a single violent event, causing bubbles to form, but maybe he was looking at it from the wrong place. Maybe these bubbles had nothing to do with the disintegration of the star. Maybe because of the abundance of stars in the core. Maybe dozens of stars packed with hundreds of teeth went supernova at the same time and ejected these gas clouds beyond the galactic core. We may never be sure which is the case, but the bubbles continue to emit an odd amount of radiation even now. We may never be sure which one is correct, but these spots continue to emit visible amounts of radiation. Although these giant blobs are so large, they cannot be seen with the naked eye because despite their high temperature, the gas inside is extremely thin, making them nearly invisible. The Fermi team was able to discover that something inside this bubble produces gamma rays, the highest energy type of light. These particles are mostly electrons, but probably in heavier elements, they bounce around and emit distinctive gamma rays. But don't think that gamma ray or all that high energy particles can produce when cosmic rays collide, performing the intricate subatomic dance of matter and energy. Which neutrinos are released? Neutrinos are fundamental parts that have a speed close to the speed of light and almost do not interact when passing through materials with zero electrical charge. Located at the South Pole, the Ice Cube Observatory uses 1 cubic kilometer of pure Antarctic water ice as a neutrino detector. A high-energy neutrino passing through the ice interacts with a water molecule, triggering a domino-like chain reaction that causes more familiar particles to form and glow. Despite all this, Ice Cube isn't the best at pinpointing the exact origin of a neutrino, but it has discovered at least 10 of these little ghosts coming from the general direction of the two Fermi bubbles. But whether they really come from the Fermi bubble or from other parts of the universe is still a matter of debate by scientists. Another unknown thing about these bubbles is how cosmic rays from these Fermi bubbles produce gamma rays. Perhaps there is a single set of interactions inside these bubbles that produce the right kind of neutrinos that both gamma rays and an ice cube can detect. And understanding the nature of the bubble could give us important information as we move forward. Recently, a team of researchers combed through all the available data, including results from the high altitude of water to the Rankine detector, and combined this information with various theoretical models to look for bubbles. In research, scientists discovered another new structure inside Fermi bubbles, which they called irosita bubbles. Visible only in X-ray emissions, these bubbles are significantly hotter and less energetic than Fermi bubbles. Given their similar shapes and common midpoints, it's likely that Fermi and irosita bubbles have a physical connection and emerge from the same galactic fireworks explosion millions of years ago. As we mentioned earlier, scientists can't explain how this happened, but they suspect that the newly found Fermi bubble appears more like the result of an explosion. The burst of energy from the Milky Way's black hole star was countering the amount of energy potential needed to inflate that. Researchers have calculated that an energy release equivalent to 100,000 supernovas required to create these structures. This is comparable to X-ray energy oscillations observed in other galaxies with active black holes at their centers. And even if this hypothetical blast occurred millions of years ago, the effects of blasts of this size would take a very long time to heal, so the effects are visible. The discovery of new irosita X-ray bubbles was made using the irosita X-ray telescope, which travels every 6 months on the Russian-German Spectra EEG satellite. The telescope also scans the entire sky, so scientists hope that studying the bubbles could lead to the discovery of violent events in the galaxy's past. That's all for now. What do you think about these bubbles? Please don't forget to share your thoughts with us. For more such content, don't forget to like our video and subscribe to our channel.